everyone, welcome to Glowing Secrets, powered by Glow. They say outer beauty is a gift and inner beauty is an accomplishment. The beauty I have with me today is really gifted and she has accomplished her inner beauty too. So I want to welcome Sachini Ayendra. How are you?
I'm good.
Well, Sachini, firstly, I want to talk about beauty. What is beauty to you? How do you describe beauty?
I would say, like, I have been in an industry where beauty is like much highlighted and it's everyone focuses on the outer beauty of a person. But over the years, I have learned one thing. It's just that however we may look, it's just that how comfortable we are in ourselves. Because we could be like, a person could look at another person and say like, oh my gosh, she's so beautiful, but sometimes that person do not feel that about that person or about
she doesn't
yourself.
Feel beautiful.
Yeah, I have seen that, like, with so many people. Like, I would look at a person and say, oh my gosh, she's so pretty, but when you talk to her, she has no confidence. Like, she doesn't even know that she's beautiful. So it's about,
and she's quick to highlight her faults, right?
Yes, yeah. Yes. So I think it's about how you feel about yourself. Maybe you're not so good looking according to beauty standards, but if you're so confident about how you look, about your skin color, about your hair, everything, I think that's true beauty.
They say that some beautiful women are not beautiful within. When they are beautiful in their exterior, the interior is not beautiful. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I think I have seen people over the years who are like that. That I think it's about how evolved you are spiritually. So I think it doesn't really have to do anything with how you look from the outside, but about how you grow as a person spiritually when you age, especially. You know, we don't look at the same things how we look at those things
looked
when
at,
we were younger.
Yeah,
so I think as people, like, we have to evolve spiritually. That's how, that's when
we
you
build.
Become a better person as a person. So I think that's the I think conflict between the exterior and the
interior.
Yeah. Okay.
When you took part in Miss Sri Lanka for the world pageant, Miss World pageant, I mean, it was some time ago.
Yeah.
So how has it changed when you look at pageants today? I mean, you have been as a you have been a judge many a times in the recent past, but at looking back at your pageant and today's pageants, how has things changed?
Oh my
beauty
God.
Wise,
I think it's a world of a difference, because I think back when we were contesting or we were even models, there were only very, very few people in the industry. So there, it was like very limited. Everything was very limited. There was no social media.
I think that is the biggest blessing in disguise, I think.
Yeah. Because we had only like actual like different platforms like TV, radio and newspapers. That's all we had. And now if you want to become a star or if you want to go anywhere, you can just start with your own social media. So we didn't
you
have
can brand thing. Yourself, you can promote yourself.
Yeah, and you can not be, you cannot even have any talent, but you could have like so many millions of followers. So we didn't have that. So life was different, I would say. So back then, I think people who were really passionate, committed, dedicated to their work were in the industry, remained in the industry. Everyone else just fell off down the road. So now I think there's so much of competition. There's so much of, I think I would say, newcomers in the industry. So everyone has this easy way of being exposed to anyone. Like, you could be like posting a beautiful photograph of yourself and then the next minute you can have a film director calling you and saying, I casted you for my movie. It's that easy now. You know, you don't even need, like, back in the day we had to have like a real profession of photographer to photograph us and
a real portfolio.
Yes,
and then you have a screen test and
exactly.
There was a process.
We had to actually be shown in a newspaper to be seen. But right now you can just post a photograph, take a photograph yourself and post it, and then you could be seen, right? So, but then again, I think right now you have to be extremely good to get somewhere also.
Because the competition is so high.
Yeah.
So it's a good and bad thing both.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, let's talk about you being a mother.
Yeah.
You have two beautiful daughters.
Yeah, thank you.
And keeping up with this beauty standards, beauty regimes.
Yeah.
How do you manage to do that?
Well, I think that's because I keep up. I mean, whatever my beauty routine or my exercise routine, my diet, I keep up everything. I would never deny saying, no, I don't do anything, I just look like this. No, I do work at it. That's because I want to look good. We all age. So I want, even when I'm really old, I want to look good at my age. And I think even if I have children, even if I have all the work in the world, I never want to neglect myself, because I think I love myself. So because I love myself, I don't want to look in the mirror and say like, oh my God, you look so
what
bad.
What happened to you?
Yeah, I never would. I did look at myself at one point in my life and ask that question. That was when I was just after I had my second child. I looked so bad at that time. I used to go in front of the mirror every morning because I'd put on like 16 kilos. And I look at myself and I'm like asking, oh my God, like what happened to you? Like you look so bad.
What is your secret to get back to this beautiful self?
Well, I went on a very strict diet. And then you have to keep up every day. You have to discipline yourself. No. Like you can't, okay, you can just like, example, let's say diet. You can relax and eat once in a way, but generally 99% of the time you have to stick to your diet. You can't cheat. It's just keeping up. Like there was a time like I felt like, okay, my skin is getting bad. So then I decided to myself, no, I have to look after my skin. I have to keep up with my skin.
Yeah, because the skin is the most important part.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I do work at it every day. You have to not neglect yourself. So if you have a lifestyle of eating healthy, exercising, getting proper sleep,
drinking loads of water.
These things don't take a lot of time. Mm-hmm. If you really look into the time that
and prioritize.
Yeah. So after a while it becomes your life, a part of your life, or it's your lifestyle. The way you eat, the way you do things, the way you whatever. So once it becomes a lifestyle, then it's easy, you know. As now, actually looking back, I started being on a healthy diet in my early 20s. So now when some people say like, oh my God, like how do you look younger or what you do, like I'm like thinking, and I'm like thinking, yeah, I have been on a healthy diet.
It's become
rice.
A normal thing for you.
Yes, I've stopped eating rice like way early in my 20s. And
Stopped eating rice completely, or?
No, I eat maybe once in a while, but in general, I do not eat rice. So
you don't get cravings and stuff?
No, I don't anymore. That's the thing. When it's your lifestyle, you don't even get cravings anymore, because your mind and your body is used to that. You have set your mind to kind of be in this particular diet, this particular routine, and that's it. It doesn't ask for anything else.
So I guess it's all in the mind.
It's all in the mind. And I'll quickly tell you how I got rid of the rice thing. So whenever we travel, we have this craving like, oh my God, I want to eat Sri Lankan rice, I need to eat curry. I was also like that. So then I read this book, right? And when I read that book by a famous doctor, a US doctor, and after I read the book, it said how harmful sugar is to your body, right? And then rice
turns into sugar.
Sugar, because it's a carbohydrate. And then I realized, oh my God, rice is bad for us, you know. So it was just that thought
instantly
that made me stop eating rice. I never got a craving. And I was so shocked. I was thinking, so it's all in your mind. There's nothing like, oh my God, I'm going to die without curry or something. It's how we have conditioned our minds to eat the food we are eating. So now I have conditioned my mind to eat like, I'm on a plant-based diet now. So just plants and vegetables. And my friends tease me. They're like, I just eat like grass
green
and vegetables.
Greenery.
So now I've just conditioned my mind so much to eat that. I just can't eat any other junk. Like I feel sick if I eat some junk.
That's great. I mean, the mind is the biggest tool.
Yes.
Now, moving into something different, we see you in beautiful attires. In when you go for a function, you're in something different, and you are not afraid to experiment. You will wear whatever the designer gives you, and you'll carry it well too.
Yeah.
So, what is your preparation like when you have to go for a function? Like how early do you prepare, and what is the process?
Well, first of all, I love clothes. I have a huge closet. And I love collecting clothes. So I have clothes over the years I have collected. So when I have something like, let's say, a big event, my first thought is like, oh my God, what am I going to wear for this? Like, I get excited, right? So then I, depending on the time frame, even if I have 2 days, I'll pull off something. But usually you have a bit of time. So I would think of like, okay, what do I feel
so
like
you look
wearing?
At what suits you? What suits the function?
No, I just think of my mood.
Oh, okay.
Right?
At that particular time?
No, I would feel like I would have a feeling of how I want to look. Like, it's like this, like a certain times. Periods of times I have different modes, like okay, this time I want to look like very sleek and something like that. Oh. or then I would be like, I want to be like so fashionable. Like,
so do you follow anyone?
No, not really, but I have a set of designers that I rotate with, so I
you
tell
give them the idea.
Yeah, I tell them like I want to look wear something really crazy. And they would be like,
do it all.
Yeah. And I would always work with the designer. So if the designer gives me some, because I think I have become like that, because I have worn like almost every design under the sun, like every basic, like the A line or the this or that. So I am really bored with like wearing the same old thing. So I would talk with the designer and I would say like, what about if you do something like this, then. So we always explore and experiment, and then so that's how I end up wearing something. But still, like when I look back, I'm like, no, I could have done something better. You know, I look back and I, so it's an evolving thing, you know.
Yeah, it's nice because you see a lot of Hollywood stars, a lot of Bollywood stars, they experiment. And when it comes to Sri Lankan people, they are a little stagnant, I would say.
Yes.
They are in one position.
Yeah,
they don't want to go out of the way, out of the box. And, you know, be unique, be themselves. But they like to do it, they'll appreciate.
Yeah, especially so, designers, they love people who they could experiment something with, or they who would love to wear their creation. So because designers, they come up with all sorts of designs. So that's why I think every piece of garment, it's an art. Like there's art in it. So without just basically wearing the same old thing, I think we should just be more creative.
Quickly, let's say from the time you wake up till the time you go to sleep, what is your beauty regime like?
Well, when I wake up in the morning, I would just basically do my usual cleanser, toner, moisturize. Yeah. And then if I'm stepping out, it's a must that I have to wear sunscreen. That I started recently because, even if we don't really, I talk about it this all the time, even if we don't really pay attention to it, over time we can get many wrinkles because of sun exposure. We don't really have to be out in the sun, but
the glare alone is enough.
If you have the glare, it can sunburn your skin, so you have to wear a sunscreen. And then I drink lots of water, and then I would exercise depending on my day. And in the night, I just cleanse and tone moisturize, that's all. But every month I go for my facial or my facial treatment. That is my latest discovery. Like, no matter what you put on your face, like how expensive your cream is, it does not matter if you don't monthly deep clean your face. Like, even if you put something, put a good cream on your face, it doesn't really absorb if you have so many impurities in your skin.
So cleansing is like the most important thing in your beauty
I think
regime.
Cleansing, but twice a day, not more than that. But every month, I think once a month, you have to deep clean your face. You have to go to a beauty parlor or whatever, wherever you're going. A deep clean, a clean up or a facial or something like that, I would say do it once a month. That's very important.
You have two daughters. What is the advice that you will give young girls who will think of you as a role model, beauty-wise, like to be happy with themselves, or what kind of an advice can you give them?
I would say, like, however you may look, always think that you are beautiful inside out, and always be confident. Whoever may say whatever, because now we see social media, there are social media bullies writing very nasty things that can scar a person forever. So never listen to anyone, but just believe in yourself. Think you're beautiful, be confident, and lead your life.
Well, confidence is the key. Thank you so much, Sachini, for being on my show and sharing your secrets. I think that was a very valuable secret, avoiding rice and, you know, the routines that you have. So thank you once again, and
thank
it was
so
lovely
much.
Having you.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
Glowing Secrets will be with you again with another celebrity and more secrets.